What's going on, everybody? This is Darian with Darian's Creations. Today we're going to get started. As you can see, I have my iPad Pro. I've got my Apple Pencil. Let's go ahead and open up. Let's open up ArtStudio Pro this time. What am I doing right here? Nothing. Okay. And in this time, we're going to go ahead and open up Pinterest and have that to the side. Move that over some more. Oh, look, cats. Cats, people, birds. I'm going to go ahead and move myself away. I don't think I can.
Nope.
I don't think I can move myself away. All of these things are actually... Wow. What is this? Zazu? Is this Zazu? Oh, well, either way, that doesn't even let me move it. I wonder how that works. Or it does. That's crazy. So I'm going to be using this color right here. Actually,
nope.
I'm going to go more towards a blue, like a deeper blue, something in this specific vicinity. And I have my layer over here. I'm just going ahead and pinching like that. Currently, I am using the crayon, right? So on the pencils area, I am down here using the crayon pencil. So that one right there. And if I wasn't, I was probably using the rough. Either way, rough and crayon, to me, very much similar. You know, I do like how it works. So this app has updated, so you can do something like that to get your rough drawings in. Now, I also have this right here, which was a gift. It just says wireless keyboard, but it's one of these. Something that you can go ahead and fat finger. So as you can see right here, it has like eraser and brush. So if I hit that, you can see it being selected from going back and back and forth. So I can keep my left hand on this and kind of leave it over here and do things like change full screen or whatever I need to do. Change the brightness. I'm not going to do any of that. So let's get started. I see a bird. So I want to go ahead and just start by opening up and giving myself like a big oval shape. Once again, this is, good Lord, why is my canvas acting as messed up as it is? I want to do something like this, right? And in that, I'm going to go ahead and you'll see me start to put in the beak. I think it's called a Hornbill.
Nope.
Something. I forgot what the heck kind of a creature this is. If I'm not mistaken, it's something like that, though. Woo. Yeah. And in this, let's see where the eye would be. Let's just go ahead and say the eye would be right here. Probably much smaller than the way I'm doing it. Let's move this around just a little bit, go back to the brush, and kind of do that from the eye. If the eye was to drop straight down, I do have more of a, you know, something like this, which would probably have gone more into that portion of the beak. And just because, let's just go ahead and kind of make this eye a little bit more dominant, right? Yeah, don't worry about that. All right, it's got some sort of covering where the red is at. So if I was to do something similar to this, and I knew all of this part right here was red, I could see down here and something like that. Over here, let's go ahead and just transform this entire thing and make it smaller, and then I can move it probably a little bit different. Go ahead and hit the exit on, oh my Lord, whoops, transform, and move it down, hit processing, put myself back down. And then kind of finish off where let's just say, if this was this messed up hair feathers. That neck is way too wide, but that's fine. Right, and then I'm just going to go ahead and kind of put some sort of like vibes in here, like this. Coming back, and then just a big kind of area for what I assume would be the breast of this creature. Right, we have breasts, men, we have breasts. It's not just females. Matter of fact, depends on your worldview. If you believe Adam was here before Eve, he had breasts before she did. I might need to actually shrink this up some more, or just leave it somewhat like that. And let's see. These are here where I would have the legs on this creature. You guys tracking? You guys following me? You guys following me? You following me? So now that I have that, I'm going to go ahead and put another layer over the top of it. It's got an X because there's currently nothing on it. The minute I put something on it like that, you'll see that it has that there. Now that I went back, it still has an X, but I want to drop the opacity down on this main layer. And I'm going to drop it. So 100%, I'm going to take it down to like 30s, 40s. But now I want to make sure I didn't mess that up and actually select the layer I want. And I will come in here and do a little bit more detail of something that I see. And if I noticed I made the eye way too big or something to that effect, then this is where I kind of go in here and sort of clean most of this up. One of my favorite things to draw outside of big cats are birds. And I have no clue why. I think it's because I was decent at drawing a few birds just throughout my life. I'm doing my own thing right here. Nothing I'm using a reference for, just something I felt like doing. So if you're looking at that bird saying, what part of that are you drawing? None of it. Let me go ahead and erase some of that, to be honest with you, and then kind of do the as if the bird's eye. Let's just do that. So right now I currently have my iPad Pro mounted on a tripod, and it's in front of me, on just sitting right in front of me. I'm using a speaker from Movo. I actually like it quite a lot. Like I said, I'm not sure specifically which species of bird this is. I think it is the great hornbill of some sort, and not sure if it's just called a great hornbill or is a great hornbill something else. Is hornbill the name of the actual species? Where does this kind of stop? Directly under the eye-ish. Let's go ahead and erase some of that. And then this is where, like, if I need it to do something, I will do that. So my initial part was here, and now I want it down further to where I just put it. That's just me. You do not have to do this. This is what makes art fun at times. This won't be a long video. I will not be doing a long video whatsoever, and I kind of want to just like have people understand, like, this is my process at times. I do not have the same process every single time I do art. I can change my art style, like I change my shoes, and there are some days where I don't even remember who I am. I'll just be like, how in the heck did I draw that thing last week? And I'll try and redraw it, and it'll look like complete butt. And I won't even understand what I'm doing, as if I've never picked up a pencil. I've never done a single drawing in my life. And I'm not going to lie, it can be kind of annoying. But the biggest thing I would say is have fun. Just have fun doing it. And if you can have fun doing it, you will like probably enjoy doing art again. I'm currently waiting to go to the island of Cyprus, Mediterranean island of Cyprus. I'll be doing that in a few days. I'm gonna see of what I can find while I'm out there, see what I could draw while I'm out there. I'm looking at other things for this. This bird specifically looks like it's got little ridges in its beak. Like I said, don't slave your reference, just use it as a reference specifically. The reason that I actually am doing a little bit more than what you see is because I want to make sure I'm anatomically correct on some of it. Now, you can draw mythical creatures, but it still has to read anatomically correct. So if you wanted to draw a griffin, or you wanted to draw a centaur, which is like a human and a horse, you can't just make up and put the horse's leg to be like human legs. Well, you can, but you have to make sure it still reads as human legs on a horse's ass. So, either way, those are some things that, let's go ahead and just darken some of this in a bit. That is a big deal. And let's kind of add to the eye and give it some more depth. Or at least let's attempt to give it some more depth. I know the feathers, right at the back of the eye, like kind of where we would do our, like where women would do their cat eye in this area. This is where the feathers start to come in this way and up this way on the head, where they start to merge at this point right here. That's very vital when you're studying a creature. But then they overall and overwhelmingly will swoop down kind of in this direction. So making sure you do something like that. Like I said, do your own feathers, do your own like sort of thing. Hopefully this makes sense to somebody. Hopefully it makes sense to somebody. I'll go ahead. Now that I'm over here, for some reason, I just need to, for me, I need to darken some of this in. It's starting to mess me up visually if I don't do any of it, because then I'm going to start to lose track of what I'm actually doing. And there's a point where I don't need the underlying reference image, not reference image, the underlying sketch that I had just done in the beginning, that I dropped the opacity down to about 38%, 40%, something like that. I'm not going to need it here in the near future. But hopefully you can see kind of what I'm doing. And like I said, just there's some markings, some stuff up here. Try and make it make sense on the contour of the beak itself. There's different patterns on this bird's beak, and you just put in things like that. Like I said, you want to make sure things are going to be anatomically correct. I don't want to just start putting random stuff on this bird or where I think it goes. But at the same time, that's where you start to develop or find your art style in the first place. So don't be afraid to do that. I know a lot of people only like drawing portraits, only people, and then if they do, they only like drawing women, and there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, you will go ahead and you will have a very niche type of whatever you want to call it, like subscriber base, fan base, people who only want to see your female drawings and stuff like that. If I wanted to do that, I mean, and I've gone through phases in my art journey where I only drew females, I only drew portraits, I only drew birds, I only drew cats, things like that, because it helped me in my studies of said group to, can I draw that? And I noticed drawing women and men, although in today's culture we're one and the same, through an artist's eyeball we are similar, but we're nothing alike. So once again, I'm going to do something like that. I know there's really big pockets into this, like the throat neck area of this creature. So let me So far, I'm just going to go ahead and kind of add a little bit of color to this as well. Now, I'm not in Procreate, which is rare, or at least for me it's rare, because I love that app. I love Procreate. And matter of fact, I don't even know I did that. Let me just add a new layer on top of that, just because I can go ahead and make these all together if I want to later on. So let me just go ahead and add some sort of a reflection in the eye, and then go back to that original color, go back on that initial layer, and kind of start to darken in this part of the eyeball. Let me go ahead and lower that, like the roundness part of it. Then I'm also going to go ahead and kind of big brush, going to put some tone underneath it as well. And it doesn't always look good. You know, I'll zoom in, zoom out, and kind of look at it and say, oh, wow, that looks nothing like what I was initially trying to go for. But it's still fun for me. And, yeah. So I will continue to do something like this. And hopefully this gets people to understand, you know, what you're actually looking for on your actual images and stuff like that. Mainly studying, like I said, the pattern on the neck. So I can see right here, there are patterns over here. There are some straight downs that are kind of all merging towards the center of this thing. And they're just doing something like that. And I will just draw the bird as I see it right there. And it, like I said, it does not have to be a slave or reference. If I wanted to, let's just say I wanted to go ahead and take that part out and start adding some other random parts, as if this bird had some very different type of feathering, right, like that. And you know what I mean, a lot of peacocks and stuff like that have really, really beautiful feathers and designs on them, and something like that. So let's say I wanted to draw something like that, and then later when I get into it, I'll color it. Oh god dang, you got hair all over the place. I might leave that and I might not, but I just kind of want to give you guys an example as to how I start to draw. I will use Procreate or ArtStudio Pro, Ibis Paint X, there's another one, and I just start using each app so I don't get too scope locked on one app. Sometimes one app will crash. Matter of fact, unfortunately, I've had a lot of issues with Procreate lately. It has been crashing on me, where I will try and do a transform thing or a move thing, something like that, and ooh. And then it will get stuck where I can only close the app out, and then I have to reopen it and do it again. And trying to do a video similar to this actually sucks in the middle of that video. And it's not a really good thing for Procreate for people to want to do a video utilizing their product and it starts to crash in the middle of it. But at the same time, you got to be understanding of what the gear and the apps and tools and all how technology works. And if their app is crashing right now, I wouldn't recommend just doing it. Although I still use Procreate for 97% of all the things I do. However, I do have a little bit more fun at times with the brushes in ArtStudio Pro. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this video off here for now. I'm just gonna leave it like that for now. Like I said, I'm gonna get back to it off camera, and then I'll post the other, like the finished product where I'm done with it, on my Instagram account, which is also called Darian's Creations. Please go over there, follow it if you want to go ahead and see stuff like that. If you'd like, dariancreations@gmail.com, you can go ahead and submit things like your pets, your creatures, a person, somebody you would like me to draw, and I'll see if I can draw it to the best of my ability. I am not a great artist. I just have fun doing art, and that is where it becomes fun for me. So, yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Please like, subscribe, comment, share, all of that stuff. This is Darian's Creations, and I am out.